Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Let's Crack OPSC. In this video I am going to tell you each and every aspect of ozone layer. Ozone layer is a very important topic which is going frequently asked. This particular topic is frequently being asked in prelim, mains as well as in interview. So today we will discuss each and every aspect of ozone layer. After watching this video, you will not be having any doubt regarding ozone layer. And always, this particular topic is very important. So you can make a note of it. And I hope you have already watched our health science related video, that is science and tech. And this video we will cover on ozone layer. Ozone layer is a dynamic concept. As OPSC and Odisha Forest Service, both the exams are having common prelims. So environment and ecology takes a very high weightage in prelim examination. So you have to be very thorough about ozone layer and other aspects of environment. Today we will discuss about environmental issues, that is ozone layer. So let's discuss ozone layer, that is otherwise called as O3. It is called as O3. Found in stratosphere. It is basically ozone layer is found in stratosphere starting from 10 km to 50 km. That is the range in which stratosphere is existing in our atmosphere, and it is found in this particular thing. So stratosphere is as low as 7 km in the polar region and 17 km in the equator region. So as we move from equator towards pole, we will see a very high, it is slowly come down. As in the equator it is 17 kilometers, and when we will move towards pole, slowly the stratosphere layer comes down to 7 kilometers. 17 at the equator to 7 kilometers in the polar region. Then stratosphere is temperature rises with height, very important. It is inverse to troposphere. Troposphere, what happens when you go up slowly, the temperature falls, but in stratosphere temperature rises when you will go up, that is in the stratosphere. Then ozone layer, how the ozone layer is being formed. It's a ozone layer is a unstable molecular oxygen. And when sun radiation breaks oxygen element by UV light, ultraviolet rays. When sun rays come, they come with ultraviolet rays and they fall in the ozone layer. Oxygen atom immediately bond with O2 to form O3. Oxygen atom immediately bond with O2 to form O3. O3 is being formed. So ozone layer near the earth surface is regarded negatively. It is very important. Ozone layer is very helpful for the humanity when it is present in the stratosphere level. But when it is at the surface of the earth, it is very harmful for humans. It is very harmful as it is a component of smoke. Smoke is what? Smoke plus fog, that makes you smoke. This is the smoke. Then ozone reduces human lung capacity. When ozone, if it is there in the lower layers of atmosphere, that is in the surface level, what it causes, the lung capacity, it reduces the lung capacity. Ozone reduces the human lung capacity, very important. What is the negative consequences of ozone? You have to write human lung capacity. Ozone is upper troposphere, is greenhouse, produces global warming. What happens? Whenever ozone is present in upper layer of troposphere, when it is present in upper layer of troposphere, it produces greenhouse effect. Greenhouse or global warming. Well, what happens when the sun rays came? It traps the heat and that causes global warming. So it is very important that O3 in the troposphere is very very problematic for the humanity. Then ozone in stratosphere is necessary and useful and protects from UV rays. When ozone will be present in the stratosphere from 10 km to 50 km, when it is present in the stratosphere, it is very much helpful for the humanity. Ozone in stratosphere necessary and useful and protects UV rays. UV rays, when sunlight comes, it gets reflected. Means most of the harmful chemical, light of sun unable to penetrate into the ozone layer, which is very helpful for the humanity. Then ozone found in stratosphere from 15 to 35 km. Generally ozone layer is found between 15 to 35 km. It is very important. Then ozone layer of 2 to 3 mm thick but filters UV ray. Very important. Ozone layer is not very thick. It is only 2 to 3 millimeter. Only 2 to 3 millimeter, that is a layer which reflects the harmful ultraviolet lights from the sun and back to the atmosphere. Then ozone removes ultraviolet B, that is ultraviolet B solar radiation, which can damage the cellular DNA. If the ultraviolet B radiation comes inside, what it will do? It will make a problem in cellular level DNA. In our cellular DNA, it may cause problem. Ultraviolet B ray causes skin cancer, eye damage, cataracts, and impacts the immune system in human. What is the problem if ultraviolet B rays reaches Earth? It will cause skin cancer. Yes, it will cause skin cancer. Then eye damage. It will cause the eye damage. Then cataract related to again eye. Then impact immune system in a human. In immune system also it will cause disturbance. Ultraviolet B in plants reduces crop yield, damage to forest ecosystem, decrease population in the phytoplanktons in the ocean. When ultraviolet B rays come inside the atmosphere and reaches the earth, what it causes in the plant? It reduces the crop yield. Ultraviolet B rays reduce the crop yield. Second, forest, it damages the forest ecosystem. Then decreases the population in the phytoplankton in ocean. In ocean, what ultraviolet B? It decreases the phytoplankton. Then natural catalytic cycle involving nitrogen oxide and hydrogen oxide help to stable ozone layer. Natural catalytic cycle involving nitrogen oxide and hydrogen oxide help to stable ozone layer. It helps to stable the ozone layer. These two, nitrogen oxide and hydrogen oxide. Rowland and Molina theory related to ozone hole. You have to remember this. Rowland and Molina, these were the two scientists who they worked on the ozone layer. Specially they were from California University, Harvard, especially Harvard University, they did research. So they may ask you in a MCQ that Rowland and Molina theory related to. So you have to write it as ozone layer. Then ozone hole, you can say ozone hole. Montreal Protocol to protect the ozone layer by phasing out ozone depleting substances, signed in 26 August 1987, came into force on 26 August 1989. Very very important. Montreal Protocol. Montreal Protocol is what? To phasing out all the ozone depleting substances from atmosphere. And it was signed in 26 August 1987 and it came into effect just 2 years after. Means most of the people, most of the countries, if you will see, most of the developed nations, they are closer to the Arctic region. They are closer to very very high regions. Then high altitude, the high You can say latitude. The high latitude, all this, they are facing problems, skin cancer, they are having this kind of impact. That is the reason why they reached consensus in a very faster way, and the Montreal Protocol came into effect just 2 years after it was signed, in 26 August 1989. Treaty is to control chlorine and bromine. These are the two very important aspects. Chlorine and bromine, these really impact the ozone layer. Chlorine and bromine are the two substances which create damage to the ozone layer. Nitrous oxide, not controlled by Montreal Protocol. Montreal Protocol is generally to do chlorine and bromine control, but this nitrous oxide, not controlled by Montreal Protocol. Then we will discuss about global warming. These are the gases which are having atmospheric lifetime in years, and what is the green global warming potential. Carbon dioxide, CO2, it is having around 50 to 200. It is lifetime is 50 years to 200 years. It is global warming potential is 1. Methane, CH4, its lifetime is, atmospheric lifetime is 12 years. If methane is released, it will stay there in the atmosphere up to 12 years. And it is potential is 21 times. Means 21 times of carbon dioxide. Then nitrous oxide. Nitrous oxide's lifetime is around 120 years. And it is 321 times of carbon dioxide. 321 times. Then hydrofluorocarbon 23. Its atmospheric lifetime is 264 years. And it is 11,700 times more capable to damage the global warming potential of CO2. Then carbon tetrafluoride, then it is around 50,000 years is the time, and its global warming potential is 6,500 times that of carbon dioxide. So I hope this particular aspect of topic is very clear. It is very, very important. Do make a note of it. Do revise in the timely interval. It is a very dynamic aspect, and it will definitely going to be asked in the prelims, mains as well as interview. So be very thorough about this particular thing. Watch this particular video 2 or 3 times so that you have a clear-cut idea about ozone layer, ozone hole, and Montreal Protocol 26 August 1987 came into effect on 26 August 1989. And it is Montreal Protocol is to control chlorine and bromine, but it leaves out nitrous oxide. So, and all this global warming gas potential. I hope the video is very clear about ozone layer. We will be making many more such informative videos. Do like and subscribe our channel. If you are new to our channel, do share with your friends. Do remember to subscribe our motivational channel. It will help you to give a direction about your thinking process as well as motivation to study hard. Thank you very much for watching. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.